was called in.
And the sheriff's office continues to work on both cases tonight.
Two separate cases within just a few hours of each other. WYFF News 4's Sean Mazzarello is live and local in Buncombe County with the latest on both tonight. Sean?
Michael, still an active scene out here off Holly Lane near Fletcher. Behind me is a mobile home where investigators say a woman's body was found earlier. That ambulance here, sadly, here to take away the body from the home. What we know so far is that the victim lived at that house and that she was found by a relative who came to check on her. This is video from earlier in the day when investigators were still out here. They are not saying how she died. They are interviewing people to figure out when she was last seen by anyone. We spoke with the victim's daughter who was out here earlier today.
She was a great woman, and whoever could do this to her is a heartless person.
Investigators do have a person of interest in this case. Here he is. His name, Brian Walter Jones. Detectives are also looking for a vehicle connected to this case. It's a 1994 Chevy Geo Prism, bluish gray in color with four doors. It has a North Carolina license plate number of BHY1398. So anyone who sees Jones or this vehicle is asked to call the Buncombe County Sheriff's Office. Now, before this homicide was discovered, we were with Buncombe County Sheriff's investigators at the scene of another homicide, an apparent murder-suicide in the Mount Carmel Acres community. Here's what we know about that case. Bruce Sullivan makes it his responsibility to keep his Mount Carmel neighbors safe. He regularly runs patrols on these streets at night as a community patrol officer.
It's a very safe neighborhood. The worst thing we've had in the past few years was we had another murder-suicide last Thanksgiving.
He was shocked this morning to learn the same thing appears to have happened this year during the holidays. Because around 8 o'clock this morning, deputies surrounded a home on David Court. A person who had been inside the house called 911 when they heard shots fired. When deputies got there, they found a man and a woman's body inside. They say both dead of apparent gunshot wounds. There was no forced entry into the home, leading deputies to believe all along this was a murder-suicide. Sheriff Van Duncan says today's deaths marked the 11th and 12th homicides of the year in Buncombe County.
It has been an extraordinarily busy, violent time here in Buncombe County, especially when it comes to domestic family-related violence, because that's what most of these cases relate back to.
And as of right now, investigators have not released the identities of any of the victims in these two homicides. I'm Sean Mazzarello, WYFF News 4, live and local in Buncombe County tonight.
Sean, thank you. A small